on the long white road, and the Thames go creeping on, inch by inch with a weary load, and by the power of the green hide goat, the distant goal is won. With eyes half shut in the blinding dust, and next to the open low, the beasts are pulling as bullocks must, and the shining tires might almost rust while the spokes are turning slow. With face half hid by a broad-brimmed hat that shades from the heat's white waves, and shouldered whip with its green hide plait, the driver plods with a gait like that of his weary, patient slaves. He wipes his brow, for the day is hot, and spits to the left with spite. He shouts at Bally and flicks at Scott, and raises dust from the Bekoff spot, then spits to the dusty right. Sometimes he'll stop as a matter of form in front of a settler's door, and ask for a drink, or remark it's warm, or say the signs of a thunderstorm, but he seldom utters more. And rains are bad on roads like these, and fronting his lonely home. The days together the settler sees, the wagons barked to the axle trees, or ploughing the sodden loam. And then when the roads are at their worst, the bushman's children are here. The cruel blows of the whips reversed, while bullocks pull as their hearts would burst, and bellow with pain and fear. And thus with glimpses of home and rest is the long, long journey done. And thus tis a thankless life at the best, his distance fought in the mighty west, and the lonely